the given figures carefully. Write the fraction for the shaded collection of balls. Now you can see a circle here. We have to write the fraction for the shaded collection of balls. Now before you write the fraction, you have to know what is the total number of balls here in the picture. In this circle together you have 10 balls. And to fraction for the shaded collection of balls will be 4/10 or 4/10. How do you write the shaded collection in decimal fraction? It is nothing but 4/10 can be written as 0.4. So this is the fraction, this is the decimal fraction. So we understand that 4/10 is equal to 0.4. Same way. Now look at this ribbon. You can see 10 parts here in the ribbon, or this ribbon has been divided into 10 equal parts. What is the fraction for the shaded portion? You can see that 1, 2, 3, 6 and 7. 7 out of 10 parts or 7/10 are shaded. Same thing. How do you write this in decimal fractions? This can be written as 0.7. Now look at the next picture. Here also in the third picture, you see different types of balls. So what is the fraction? The fraction for the orange shaded balls, first you should count the total number of balls. Here together there are 25 balls. Out of 25 balls, 7 balls are shaded. Fraction for the orange shaded balls is 7/25 or 7/25. How do you write this in decimal fraction? Same way, you see another example here. This strip has been divided into 20 equal parts. And out of 20 equal parts, 11 are shaded. So the fraction for this shaded portion is 11/20 or 11/20. What is the decimal fraction of these two fractions? This is what we are going to learn in our today's class. So before moving on to that, let us see one more example. So what is the fraction for the shaded portion? Now totally here there are 100 blocks. Out of 100 blocks, 15 are shaded. So we know to write this in decimal fraction as 0.15. Same way here, out of 100 blocks, 34 are shaded. So this fraction can be written as 0.34 in decimal fractions. Now we will see how to write the fractions whose denominator is not 10 or the higher powers of 10 as decimal fractions. So here, when the denominator is not 10 or the powers of 10, you need to convert the denominator into 10 or the higher powers of 10. Now convert 7/25 to the fraction having 100 as the denominator, because here we cannot have 10 as the denominator because 25 is greater than 10. So first you have to convert 25 to 100. So write the fraction as it is. How do you get 100 here in the denominator? What should you do? So you have to multiply 25 4 times. So 25 4 times gives you 100. When you multiply the denominator with the number, the numerator also has to be multiplied with the same number. So multiply 7/4, 7 4s are 28. So the decimal fraction of 7/25 is nothing but 0.28. Same way, what will be the decimal fraction of 11/20? Now we do not have 10 or powers of 10 here as the denominator. We need to convert these fractions into one of them. Now you can convert 20 into 100 again. Now divide, multiply 20 by which number to get 100? You have to multiply 20 by 5. 2 5s are 10, 2 0s are 0. So multiply the numerator also by the same number. So when you multiply 11 by 5, you get 55. When you multiply 20 by 5, you will get 100. So this can be written in decimal fraction as 0.55. So the decimal fraction of 11 20th is 0.55. Now observe these fractions. You can see that none of these fractions have the denominator as 10 or 100. The denominators are not equal to 10 or 100. Now how do we write them in decimal fractions? As we saw just now, we need to convert these fractions having the denominators as 10 or 100. Now see the first one. First number is 2/5 or 2 by 5. How do you convert 2/5 or to which number can it be converted? The denominator 5 2 times gives you 10. So we can convert the denominator to 10. First write the problem as it is. We know that 5 2 times give us 10. So write, multiply denominator by 2 and multiply the numerator also by the same number. 2 2s are 4. So the decimal fraction of 4 tenths is 0.4. Let us see the next number, half. What is the decimal fraction of half? Let us find it out. So now, which is the first number that you could get either 10 or 100? So 2 how many times gives you 10 if you ask? We get the answer as 2 5s are 10. So first write the number as it is. Multiply the denominator by 5 to get 10 as the denominator. And multiply the numerator also by the same number and write the answer, that is 5. 5 tenths gives you 0.5. So always remember, half is written as 0.5 in decimal fractions. 3/4. How do you write 3/4 in decimal fraction? So 4 how many times gives you 10? We do not get 10 when we multiply 4 by any numbers. 4 1s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 4 3s are 12. So we don't get 10 as a denominator. Now we are left with 100. So now we must see 4 how many times gives you 100. Just now when we solved the previous problems, we saw that 4 25 times or 25 4 times gives you 100. Same way, multiply the numerator also by the same number and write the answer. 25 3 times gives you 75. 25 4 times gives you 100. Now, how do you write 75 hundredths in decimal fractions? 0.75. So, 3/4 is written as 0.75 in decimal fractions. You might have heard people saying, my son has scored 41 marks out of 50 marks. Now this can be written in fractional form as 41/50. Now suppose this fractional number has to be expressed in decimal fraction. What shall we do? We have to follow one of these methods. Now 50, since it is greater than 10, you have to just convert it into hundreds. 50 how many times gives you 100? 41 divided by 50 and 50 2 times give you 100. Same way, multiply the numerator also by the same number and that gives you 84. In decimal fraction, 41 by 50 is written as 0.84. So this is how you convert the fractions into decimal fractions. Okay, now here the numbers are already converted, or numbers are the decimal fractions. How to write them in decimal numbers? We all know that 8/10 is written as 0.8. Or what is the other way of writing it? or what is the easiest way to remember it? Now see here, in the denominator, when you have 1, 0, you have to write the number, one number after the decimal point, or whatever number that comes in the numerator, you have to write it as it is. And from one digit from the right, you have to put a decimal point, and then in front of the decimal point towards left, you have to replace it with a zero. Now same thing, you have 16, write 1 and 6. Since you have 1, 0 in the denominator, after one digit from right, put a decimal point. So 16 tenths are written as 1.6. Now same way, 72 hundredths, how do you write them? Write 7 and 2 as they are. Now here there are 2 zeros in the denominator, so put the decimal point after 2 digits from right. So 1, 2, put a decimal point. In front of decimal point, you cannot leave it like that or leave it empty, so replace it with 0. So 72 hundredths can be written as 0.72. Here also, 861 hundredths. Write the number 861 as it is. 2 zeros in the denominator, so put the decimal point after 2 digits from right. 1, 2, decimal point. So 861 hundredths can be written as 8.61. in decimal fractions. So let us solve the exercise from the reader. Exercise 4.2, open page 49. Write the following fractions as decimal fractions. 8 tenth, you have 1 zero in the denominator, so one number after decimal point, or after 1 point put a decimal point and then write 0. Since you have no other numbers towards the left, write a 0. Second, 7 tenths. So write 7, after 1 point you put a decimal point, after one number put a decimal point, since there is 1 zero in the denominator. You have no other numbers in the numerator, so write 0. 3, you have 6 in the numerator and 1 zero in the denominator, so put a point after one number, then write 0. 16 tenths. Write 16. You have 1 zero in the denominator, so put the decimal point after one number from the right. So from right, after one number, put a decimal point. And you have 1 here to the left, towards the left of the decimal point. So 16 tenths can be written as 1.6. Same way, 42 tenths, 1 zero. Point after one number, so 4 and 2, after one number from right, put a decimal point. 83 by 10, 83 tenths, write 8 and 3, after one number, 1 zero, after one number put a decimal point. 7 by hundredths, 7 hundredths, so you have 7 here. You have to see carefully. Since there are 2 zeros in the denominator, you have to place the decimal point after 2 numbers from the right. You have only 1 number here, so what should you do? You don't have any other numbers here in the numerator, you can write a 0 there. Now after 2 numbers you place the decimal point, and towards the left of the decimal point you write another 0. So 7 hundredths can be written as 0.07. Same way, 72 hundredths, write 7 and 2 as they are. 2 zeros in the denominator, decimal points after 2 numbers from right, so 1, 2, and decimal point. Towards the left of decimal point you have to write a 0. Same way, write the number 8, 6, and 1. 2 zeros in the denominator, so decimal point after 2 numbers from right, 1, 2, decimal point, 8.61. This is how you convert the fractions into decimal fractions. If there is 1 0 in the denominator, one number after decimal point, 2 zeros in the denominator, 2 zeros after decimal point. These numbers are nothing but the numbers in the numerator. Okay, 10th problem, 162 tenths. So we know, write the numerator as it is. 1 0 in the denominator, put decimal point after one number from right. So after right after one number you have to put decimal, 16.2. 141 in divided by 100 or 141 hundredths. 2 zeros in the denominator, place decimal points from two numbers from right side. So 1 2 and then decimal point. So it is 1.41. 12th problem, 1461. To write the number, write the numerator as it is. 2 zeros in the denominator, decimal point after two numbers from right. So 1 2 decimal point. So it is 14.61. Now see here, the questions from 13 to 18 are the fractions whose denominators are not equal to 10 or the higher powers of 10. Here you have to convert them by multiplying the numerator and the denominator by the same number. Now 2, it can be converted into 10 by multiplying the both the numbers by 5. 3/4, we have seen it in the example, we can multiply both the numbers by 25 to make the denominator 100. Here 2/5, multiply the numerator and the denominator by 2 to make the denominator 10. 7/20, multiply both the numbers by 5 to make the denominator 100. Multiply both the numbers by 2 to make the denominator 100. Here, multiply the numbers by 4 to make the denominator 100. Here, multiply 20 by 5 to make the denominator 100. Multiply both the numbers by 4 to make denominator 100. This is how we solve these problems. It will be sent in a PDF file.